Uno, dos, uno, dos, uno, dos.
Good evening, Daniel. Hello, Lizeth. How are you?
Hello, teacher.
Hi, Carla. Welcome. How was your weekend?
Relax.
Good.
Good.
I had a very interesting weekend. First of all, on Friday, I think I told you that I had to go to migration to get my new ID. Well, I went to migration. I got to pick the person that has to be with me in migration. Because here we cannot, as foreigners, we cannot go to make the all the things in migration by ourselves. It has to be a Panamanian lawyer with us. So I went to pick the Panamanian lawyer. And when we were coming back, it was heavy traffic. And then I see that the car in front of me stopped, and I tried to stop. And I actually stopped, but without brakes. Suddenly the brakes were not working. And I didn't panic, thank God. And I started to get down the speed. Thank God it's not an automatic car, but a manual car. And I go from 3 to 2nd, then to 1st. And I stop within a meter and a half or something like that. I made the car stop without brakes. And I came from Panama to La Chorrera without brakes. And then today they fixed the car. But I was coming all the way from Panama to La Chorrera without brakes. And it was a very interesting situation. But I didn't panic, okay? I didn't panic. And moreover, since the mechanic asked me to go to his house, and I haven't get any breakfast or lunch, I went to a drive-thru McDonald's without brakes. But I need to buy something to eat, okay? Because I thought that the man will fix the car immediately. But no, he fixed it until today. It was something expensive because it cost $266. But it's better to pay that rather than not be driving without brakes. Well, that was my weekend. When I finally get home, I was realizing that I proved to myself that I have iron nerves. Well, today we will be talking about likes and dislikes, but I also made something else here, and I would like you to tell me which other subjects would you like me to search for you? Because as far as I realize, we will have about 2 days that we can study 3 subjects. Because the final lessons are very small, and I finish the 4th on Wednesday, and we will start the 5th on Thursday. But then I guess that we will be finishing about Tuesday or Wednesday with all in the the exam, the final exam. So we will have Thursday for free topics. What do you want me to look for you? What do you, what would you like to know about English? Think of it. If you have any doubts that you had all the time and nobody told you. And I also will present you the real order of the adjectives. I think I told you that I will give you that. But besides that, I would like to know which other subjects would you like to cover for Thursday. Okay, then think of any topic and let me know either here or by WhatsApp. Okay, so I can prepare the class for you. Okay, now likes and dislikes. Could you, somebody read it, please?
Me, please.
Okay, go ahead.
There are two education. One show this as how to make a living and the other how to live.
Okay. There are two educations. One should teach us how to make a living and the other how to live. Okay. Thank you. Miren qué interesante, ¿verdad? Que deberían de haber, que hay dos tipos de educación. Uno que nos enseña cómo ganarnos la vida y el otro debería de enseñarnos cómo vivir. ¿Verdad? Porque muchas veces, por estarnos ganando la vida, se nos olvida cómo vivir, ¿verdad? Y hay muchas personas que incluso dejan descuidada a la familia, ¿verdad? Por estar haciendo dinero. Y algunas veces los hijos lo que necesitan realmente es al padre. Más que el dinero que el padre pueda proveer, ¿verdad? Pero se nos olvida eso. O deberíamos de balancear, ¿verdad? Y poder hacer ambas cosas. Porque as far as I know that many people don't like the Bukele family. But as far as I know, they were because the Don Armando already died. They work hard, and Mr. Armando Bukele also were a very good student, and he likes to study, and he got a lot of diplomas and things because he likes to study. But he also gave his time to her, to their children. And that's why everybody from the opposition said that he is only a high schooler, Nayib Bukele. He was actually studying at UCA, but he thought that he was wasting his time there because he could learn more from his dad that he was learning at the classroom. And if you notice, he is very smart. And he is doing pretty well. he doesn't need all those degrees in order to run the country. But who teaches him to be what he is now? His father. Okay, because his father also gave them time, not only money. Well, we were studying about the regular adjectives. These are the regular adjectives. When they are small adjectives, you add the suffix er to make the comparative, and then than, and to make the superlative, the, and the est suffix. When it is a long adjective, we use more than the adjective and than, and to make the superlative, we use the, most, and then the adjective. The most in the adjective. Okay, this is with the regular adjectives. With the irregular adjectives, we have good, better than, the best, bad, worse than, the worst, little, less than, the least, well, better than, the best, much, more than, the most, many, more than, the most. Okay, and for example, we can say he is a tall man, but his brother is taller than him. But, well, he is a tall man. His brother is taller than him. But his father is the tallest of them. Okay? Entonces tenemos tall, taller than, and the tallest. Okay? Intelligent. Mary is intelligent. Sarah is more intelligent than Mary. But Elena is the most intelligent of all. Okay? When you are comparing two things, you use the comparatives, but when you are comparing more than two, you use the superlative. Okay. Any doubts about that? ¿Alguna duda sobre eso?
No.
No? Okay. Now, in this lesson, participants will listen to a conversation expressing likes and dislikes. Well, you have here the conversation. First, follow the reading and then we will repeat. Do you like rap, Liz? No, I don't like it very much. Do you? Yeah, I do. I'm a big fan of Eminem. I think I know him. Does he play the piano? The piano? No, he doesn't. He's a singer. Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap. So, what kind of music do you like? I really like pop music. Who's your favorite singer? Celine Dion, I love her voice. Do you like her? No, I don't like. No, I don't. I don't like pop music very much. Okay. Now listen and repeat. Do you like rap, Liz? No, I don't like it very much.
No, I don't, no, I don't like it very much.
Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, I do.
I do.
I'm a big fan of Eminem. I think I know him. Does he play the piano?
No, he doesn't. He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like?
So what kind of music do you like?
I really like pop music.
I really like pop music.
Who's your favorite singer?
Celine Dion.
I love her voice. Do you like her?
Do you like her?
No, I don't. I don't like pop music very much.
I don't like pop music very much.
Okay. Now, about Celine Dion. Do you know that Celine Dion's native language is not English? She cannot speak English. But when you listen to her singing in English, it seems to be a perfect English. But her native language is French. So she can sing in English, but because she learned the lyrics by phonetics, then they write everything with phonetic symbols, and she just follow. That way she can sing at any language. Only they need to put the phonetics and then she can read it or sing it. Okay. So you see, it is very important to know how to read phonetic symbols. When you look at the dictionary for a word, beside it, you have very strange symbols that are in brackets. Those are the phonetic symbols of how that word is pronounced. Okay. So you could learn it that way. Now, let's do it again, and then I will need some volunteers. Do you like rap, please?
Do you like rap, please?
No, I don't like it very much.
No, I don't like it very much.
Do you?
Do you?
Yeah, I do. I'm a big fan of Eminem. I think I know him.
I think I know him.
Does he play the piano?
The piano?
No, he doesn't.
He's
a singer.
He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like? I really like pop music. Who's your favorite singer? Celine Dion.
Celine Dion.
I love her voice.
I love her voice.
Do you like her?
Do you like her?
No, I don't.
No, I don't.
I don't like pop music very much.
I don't like pop music very much.
Okay. Now, volunteers. Okay, Lisette Esmeralda and Yancy Mayen. Lisette, you start.
Yes. Do you like rap, please?
No, I don't like it very much. Do you?
Yeah, I do. I am a big fan of Eminem.
I think I know him. Does he play piano?
The piano? No, he doesn't. He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like?
I really like pop music.
Who's your favorite singer?
Celine Dion. I love her voice. Do you like her?
No, I don't. I don't like pop music very much.
Okay, thank you very much. Other two volunteers? Okay, Carla and Daniel. Daniel, you start.
Do you like rock, Carla?
No, I don't like it. No, I don't like it very much. Do you?
Yeah, I do. I'm a big fan of Eminem.
I think I know him. Does he play the piano?
The piano? No, he doesn't. He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like?
I really like pop music.
Who is your favorite singer?
Celine Dion. I love her voice. Do you like her?
No, I don't know. I don't like pop music very much.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, other two volunteers. Verónica Godoy and Janet del Rosario. You start, Verónica.
Okay. Do you like rap, please?
No, I don't like it very much. Do you?
Yeah, I do. I am a big fan of Eminem.
I think I know he doesn't. He play the piano.
You say doesn't is, I know him. Does he? Is a question.
I think I know him. Does he play the piano?
Okay.
The piano? No, he doesn't. He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like?
I really like pop music.
Who's your favorite singer?
Celine Dion. I love her voice. Do you like her?
No, I don't. I don't like pop music very much.
Okay, thank you. Now, other two volunteers. Lourdes González, could you help us? And Angélica Molina, are you there? Could you help us?
Okay.
Okay.
Do you like rap, please?
No, I don't like it very much. Do you?
Yeah, I do. I am a big fan of Eminem.
I think I know him. Does he play the piano?
The piano? No, he doesn't. He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like?
I really like pop music.
Who's your favorite singer?
Celine Dion. I love her voice. Do you like her?
No, I don't. I don't like pop music very much.
Okay, thank you. I'm listening that most of you are mispronunciating the same two words. One is fun, F-U-N, fun, and the other one is kind, kind, K-I-N-D, kind, okay? Kind and fun. Now, other two volunteers. Freddy Quijano, could you help us? Freddy? What about Rodrigo? Rodrigo Vidal, could you help us? He's not there. And Jacqueline Patricia? Josué González?
Hello.
Okay, could you help us, please? Melida Sarai? Okay. Okay. You will be Liz and Josué will be Tom.
Okay.
Do you like rap, please?
No, I don't like it very much. Do you?
Yeah, I do. I'm a big fan of Eminem.
I think I know him. Does he play the piano?
The piano? No, he doesn't. He's a singer.
Oh, I guess I don't know much about rap.
So, what kind of music do you like?
I really like pop music.
Who's your favorite singer?
Celine Dion. I love her. I love her voice. Do you like her?
No, I don't. I don't like pop music very much.
Very much. Thank you. Now, let's go on. At the end of this lesson, participants will be able to ask questions in simple present using do or does along with WH question words. I don't know if I ever explained this to you, but most of the time I do. WH questions are questions that require you to give more information. Yes, no question, you can answer them just by saying yes or no, but we don't only say yes or no. When we say yes, if we are going to do short answers, it's yes, I do, no, I don't, okay? That means yes, comma, subject, and auxiliary. If it's not, it's no, comma, subject, plus auxiliary, plus not, okay? That's the way to answer in short answers. when you are requested to answer long answers, you have to use part of the question in order to answer, okay, or give the real information, okay. You can use both. And in the case of WH questions, you cannot answer them just by saying yes or no, because you have to provide the information they are requesting from you. But the yes, no question could be the base of WH questions. For example, if I say, do you study? That is a yes, no question. You may say, yes, I do, or no, I don't. That is a yes, no question. But if I say, what do you study? You have to say, what do you study? You may say, I am studying English. Okay. Now, I can ask, where do you study? And you may say, I study at home. It's an online course. Okay. I may say, why do you study? Because I want to learn another language. Because, okay. And how often do you study? I study 4 days a week. And at what time do you study? I study from 8 to 9, okay? And if you notice, you are using different WH questions, different WH words with the same yes, no question, but each time you are receiving different information. Okay, so the WH question, the WH word is very important. Okay, now the one to the left is the yes no question, and the one to the right are WH questions. Now repeat after me. Do you like rap?
Do you like rap?
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
I like it a lot.
I like it a lot.
If you notice here, the yes, I do is the short answer. And it becomes long answer by adding, I like it a lot. Okay. Now, no, I don't.
No, I don't.
Hasta ahí sería short answer. Pero como se le agrega, no, I don't like it very much, ahí ya es un long answer. No, I don't like it very much.
No, I don't like it very much.
Does he play the piano?
Does he play the piano?
Yes, he does.
No, he doesn't.
Do they like the Beatles?
Yes, they do.
They love them. No, they don't like them very much.
No, they don't like them very much.
Okay. What kind of music do you like?
What kind of music do you like?
I like rock a lot.
I like rock a lot.
What does he play?
He plays
the guitar.
He
Do they, who do they like?
Who do they like?
They like you too.
They like you too.
It is very funny because my best friend likes rock, but like Metallica. Okay. That's heavy metal. And he also plays the guitar, and he has like a little studio at his home because he composed some music, but he is a doctor. He do that like just for fun, okay? But if you look at him, he is not, he doesn't look like the classic rock fan. But I was very, very, for me, it was very, very funny to know that he likes Metallica. And he actually went to the concerts when there is Guns N' Roses and Metallica that get to El Salvador, to any Central America countries. Okay, now, they were talking about object pronouns in the platform. And then I decided to present you this, because this is the personal pronouns, because object pronouns is part of personal pronouns. As personal pronouns, we have subject and object pronouns. And we have singular and plural as a number. Singular, when we are referring to one person, and plural when we are referring to two or more persons. And we have the first, second, and third person singular. And we have the first, second, and third person plural. I told you that the first person singular is the person who is talking, okay? The second person singular is the person that I am referring to directly. Sé con quién estoy hablando directamente. And the third person singular is about who we are talking. O sea, alguien que no está en la conversación. O sea, la tercera persona es alguien de que nos estamos refiriendo a esa persona, pero no está aquí. O sea, no es alguien con quien yo esté hablando directamente. About the gender. And the first person could be used for male or female. The second person could be used for male or female. But in the third person singular, we have he as male, and she as a female, and the neuter is it, because it's for animals, for things. And then in the plural, the first one is me and someone else, the one who's speaking and someone else with me. And the second person plural is the persons are the persons who we are talking directly, and the third person singular plural is the persons that are not directly involved in the conversation. Okay, and we have the subject pronouns are the doers, and the object pronouns are the ones that receive the action. The subject is the one who does the action, and the object is the one that receives the action. Okay? So we have I, me, you, you, he, him, she, her, it, it, we, us, you, you, they, them. Okay? Any questions about this? Preguntas sobre lo que es los pronombres personales, lo que son los sujetos, que son los que hacen la acción, y los que son los objetos, que son quienes reciben la acción. ¿No? Ok. Okay, when we are referring to pronouns, I like to know, to let you know which are the pronouns. Okay, then pronouns are small words that take the place of a noun. O sea, los pronombres son pequeñas palabras que toman el lugar de un nombre. Pronouns are words like he, you, ours, themselves, some, each, okay? And we can use a pronoun instead of a noun. If we didn't have pronouns, we would have to repeat a whole lot of nouns. Sí, si no tuviéramos pronombres, tendríamos que estar repitiendo los nombres. ¿Verdad? ¿Alguna duda o consulta con respecto a esto? ¿No?
Es una pregunta, ¿se puede hacer en español? ¿Va?
Sí, sí, sí.
¿En qué momento utilizar el pronombre, ¿cómo se llama? Personal y ajá, en,
vaya, personales, en, son, y, personales son ambos.
Sí.
Tanto los subject pronouns como los object pronouns son personal pronouns.
Ajá. Y el posesivo lo... también, ¿verdad?
Pronombre
posesivo.
Ese
el
ma, es,
por ejemplo,
ese
el my, todo
ese,
eso.
Ese es posesivo.
Ajá. ¿En qué momento se utiliza? ¿En qué oraciones cada uno? Gracias, Liz.
Vaya. Por ejemplo, el sujeto, tanto el sujeto como el objeto lo puedo ocupar en una sola oración. Pero, por ejemplo, si yo digo, I give him an advice. Yo le di, ¿quién es que está haciendo la acción? Yo, porque yo le di, entonces es subject. I give him, entonces him es el object. Es a quien le voy a dar directo la información, ¿verdad? I give him an advice. Entonces, le di una advertencia, ¿verdad? O le di un consejo. Entonces, en una oración, el que hace la acción es el sujeto. Y el que recibe la acción es el objeto. ¿Entendió, José?
Sí, 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 gracias.
O sea, que en una sola oración, o sea, no necesariamente tengo que hacer una oración para subject y otra oración para object. En una sola oración pueden estar ambos, ¿verdad? Pero uno sería un personal pronoun, subject pronoun, y el otro sería personal pronoun, object pronoun. ¿Verdad? Pero eso sí, para tener un object pronoun, el verbo tiene que ser un verbo transitivo. Porque no todos los verbos son transitivos. O sea, un verbo transitivo es el que lleva la acción hacia alguien más. ¿verdad? O hacia algo más. Entonces ahí se ocupa el object pronoun, ¿verdad? Si tú revisas la lista de verbos en un diccionario, te vas a dar cuenta que cuando estás buscando el significado, ahí dice, algunos dicen transitive verb y otros dicen intransitive verb. O sea, transitive es que llevan la acción hacia algo más, ¿verdad?
No,
dígame.
No, ni deja.
Ay, Dios, no es conmigo.
Es teacher, que... en ese caso sería correcto decir she gives the flowers to her mother.
Si lo quiere decir así, sí. Pero también puede decir she gives the flowers to her.
Sin poner, pero para decir, así cuando, entiendo que lo podemos decir cualquiera, usted, ¿verdad? No, cuando sé, usted, no necesariamente cuando, la mamá.
Ajá, cuando usted dice her mother, entonces ahí en ese caso ya no sería un object pronoun, sino que sería un adjective pronoun.
Ok.
¿Verdad? Porque está poniendo un nombre después, que es mother.
Pronunciando a alguien.
Ajá. Entonces, ya es un adjective pronoun. En ese caso.
Yeah, ok, thank you, teacher.
Okay.
Al usar el object, este se vuelve un posesivo.
No necesariamente. No necesariamente. Porque el object es quien recibe la acción. ¿Verdad? Cuando usted ocupa un possessive adjective, tiene que poner después, ¿cómo se llama? Un nombre que es al que está, de quien está hablando, ¿verdad? Cuando es un adjective pronoun. O sea que, yo le di un cuadro donde estaba el subject pronoun, estaba el object pronoun, estaba el possessive adjective y estaba el possessive pronoun. ¿Verdad? Ahí estaban los cuatro. Entonces, fíjense cómo va la diferencia. Porque el possessive adjective les dije que tenía que llevar siempre un nombre después al que estaba calificando. En cambio, el object pronoun puede ir solo. Yo creo que esto se lo voy a expandir más el jueves que tenemos libre, para que veamos las diferencias entre esos, entre los possessives. Bien. Entonces, gracias. Ok. Personal pronouns. Personal pronouns represent specific people or things. We use them depending on number, singular or plural, person, first person, second person, third person, gender, male, female or neuter, and case, if it is a subject or an object pronoun. Okay. Si es el caso, si es sujeto o si es objeto. Si es sujeto, está haciendo la acción. Si es objeto, está recibiendo la acción. O sea, de eso acuérdense. Sujeto la hace, objeto la recibe. ¿Ok? We use personal pronouns in place of the person or people that we are talking about. My name is Joseph, but when I am talking about myself, I almost always use I or me, not Joseph. When I am talking direct to you, I almost always use you, not your name. When I am talking about another person, say John, I may start with John, but then use he or him, and so on. Okay. O sea, para referirme a mí, ocupo I or me. And when I'm talking directly to somebody, I use you. And when I'm talking about someone else, for a starter, I can say the name. But then when I am referring to him, I may use he or him. Okay. And for she, the same. I can say Mary or I can say she. And about it is when I am talking about objects, animals. Okay. I use it to refer to those things. And here comes some examples. In each pair, the first sentence shows a subject pronoun and the second an object pronoun. For example, I like coffee. John helped me. Now repeat. I like coffee.
I like coffee.
John helped me.
John helped me.
Si se fijan en la primera oración, el subject pronoun es I. Y en la segunda oración, el object pronoun is me. Ambos son first person singular. Ambos son primera persona del singular. Pero en I like coffee, me estoy refiriendo a mí. I like coffee.
¿Verdad? Me gusta.
¿Y quién está diciendo que le gusta el café? Yo.
Yo.
¿Verdad? En cambio, John helped me. Entonces, John me ayudó.
Me ayudó.
¿Verdad? ¿Quién es el que ayudó? John. ¿A quién ayudaron? A mí.
A mí.
¿Ok? Now, in the other examples, here we have a question. And it says, do you like coffee?
Do you like coffee?
Do you like coffee?
John loves you.
John loves you.
Si se fijan en el primero,
le están
preguntando directamente a la persona si le gusta el café. Entonces yo estoy hablando directo contigo y te digo, ¿te gusta el café? ¿Verdad? Directo. Entonces, y en el otro, le estoy diciendo, John loves you. O sea, te estoy contando que John te ama, ¿verdad? Pero John es tercera persona. Pero ¿a quién ama John? A ti. Entonces, ¿quién está recibiendo la acción?
Segunda persona.
Tú, o sea, la persona con quien yo estoy hablando directamente. Pero quien hace la acción es John. ¿Verdad? Entonces, después para el otro. He runs fast. ¿Quién es el que está corriendo rápido?
Él.
Él, verá la tercera persona del singular.
Uh-huh.
Did Ram beat him?
Él.
Ram lo venció. ¿Verdad? Entonces, ¿quién venció? Ram. ¿A quién venció? A él. ¿verdad? Entonces, siempre que estemos ocupando un object pronoun, es el que recibe la acción. She is clever. ¿Quién es la inteligente? Ella.
Ella.
Does Mary know her? Mary la conoce a ella, ¿verdad? A la inteligente. Mary la conoce, ¿verdad? Entonces, ¿quién conoce Mary? ¿A quién? A ella, pero no a Mary, sino que a ella a alguien más, ¿verdad? Tal vez aquí tendríamos que cambiar el nombre de Mary para que no se confundan. Después, it doesn't work. Can the man fix it? ¿Verdad? It doesn't work. ¿Qué es lo que no funciona? Eso.
Eso. ¿Qué es eso? Neutro. Neutro.
Yo, eso es un género neutro, o sea, podría haber sido los breakers de mi carro, ¿verdad? Que no funcionaron el viernes, ¿verdad? ¿Y can the man fix? ¿Puede el hombre arreglarlo? ¿A quién van a arreglar? A lo que está arruinado.
Eso.
¿Verdad? A eso. ¿Ok? Entonces, aquí ya estamos con los plurales. Entonces, we went home. We went home. Nos fuimos a casa. Anthony dropped us. Anthony nos llevó, ¿verdad? En carro. Entonces, pero ¿quién me estaba manejando? Anthony. ¿Pero a quién estaba llevando?
A nosotros.
¿Verdad? Entonces, si se fijan, el que hace la acción es el subject y el que recibe la acción es el object. Do you need a table for three? ¿Necesitan una casa, una mesa para tres? Did John and Mary beat you at doubles? John y Mary les ganaron en los dobles, ¿verdad? They played doubles. John and Mary beat them. Ellos jugaron dobles. John y Mary les ganaron, ¿verdad? Entonces, they podría ser el mismo them, ¿verdad? Porque están jugando dobles. O sea, ellos están jugando dobles. Pero John y Mary les vencieron. ¿A quiénes? A ellos. ¿Quiénes vencieron? John y Mary. ¿A quiénes? A ellos. ¿Verdad? Vaya, los usos. When we are talking about a single thing, we almost always use it. However, there are a few exceptions. We may sometimes refer to an animal as he or him, or she and her, especially if the animal is domesticated or a pet. O sea, si se han fijado en eso, que algunas veces no nos referimos a los gatos, si son nuestros, no nos referimos como eso. Le decimos él o la, ¿verdad? O la niña, ¿verdad? El niño, ¿verdad? Los tratamos como que fueran personitas. Entonces, y si es varoncito, es he. Y si es hembrita, es she, ¿verdad? Entonces, pero gramaticalmente nos podríamos referir a ellos como it, ¿verdad? Pero también podemos estarnos refiriendo a algunas cosas que normalmente serían it, pero hay personas que las tratan como una ella o él. Por ejemplo, yo a mi carro le digo él, ¿verdad? Bien fiel mi carrito, digo. Lo estoy tratando como personalizándolo, ¿no? Y hay personas que se refieren a sus botes, a sus embarcaciones, como ella, ¿verdad? Entonces, este, ella está bien, me gusta salir a ¿cómo se llama? A navegar en ella y cosas así. Entonces, es bastante común, ¿verdad? Y entonces, este, estos son ejemplos. This is our dog, Rusty. He is an Alsatian. Okay? He is, él. The Titanic was a great ship, but she sank on her first voyage. El Titanic era una gran embarcación, pero ella se hundió en su primer viaje. Por cierto, ni siquiera hizo la primera mitad del viaje, porque ni siquiera llegó a donde tenía que llegar. My first car was a Mini, and I treated her like my wife. Mi primer carro era una Mini, y la traté a ella como si fuera mi esposa, ¿verdad? Thailand has now opened her border with Cambodia. Tailandia ha abierto sus fronteras con Camboya. Entonces, sus, pero de ella. Her. Entonces, lo vamos a dejar hasta aquí. Este, mañana seguimos. Este, bueno, creo que sí. Voy a tratar de armar lo que les dije de lo de las possessions y de los para, no sé si para este jueves o mejor dejarlo para el otro. Yo creo que lo voy a dejar para el otro. Voy a adelantar lo más que podamos para que podamos terminar la plataforma lo más pronto y ya con el tiempo que nos quede, entonces vemos otras cosas. Pero sí, espero que me sugieran en WhatsApp cualquier duda o consulta que usted haya tenido de cuando usted recibió inglés antes, que nunca se lo respondieron. Entonces yo voy a investigar para ver de responderse. ¿Ok? Entonces, see you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
Good night.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.